Okay, good morning to all. I'm Mr. Khan, welcoming you in Mr. Khan Academy. Today I'm going to cover the part 3 of Basics of Arduino Programming series, in which I'm going to cover a program of RGB LED. And meanwhile, I'm going to cover a content of Arduino programming that is nothing but variables and operators. Before starting this video lecture, I request all my viewers, you can watch my first series, Introduction to Mechatronics. The introduction of Arduino programming series, what exactly the content I'm going to cover. In brief, I explain this video, and the part 2, just which I covered previously, the blink LED, and meanwhile I cover the theory part of verifying, saving, uploading, and some common errors in Arduino programming. The link of all these videos are available in this card icon, or you can check in description box. And one more thing, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. The subscribe button is available over here. Please hit the subscribe button to motivate me to make such video in future of also. And if it is not working properly for the mobile users, then you can visit my channel www.youtube.com/mrkhanacademy and press enter in your browser. Then my channel page will be open. There also subscribe button also available, and the various video also available. You can watch it. Okay, without delay, let's start. The topics I'm going to cover in this series, the 10 parts are there. I'm not going to discuss again in detail all those things. But as I said, already I covered these two parts, part 1 and part 2. You can watch it, the link is available. And today, I'm going to cover the part 3. Still, 7 parts are there. If you want the notification of all this video, you need to hit the subscribe my channel. The flow of this lecture, the part 1, that lecture I divided into 3 parts. In the part 1, I'm going to discuss the various components which we required in making this circuit. What exactly the circuit diagram is, how to connect all these components, and what is exactly coding. Okay, then after that we will move towards the Arduino programming, actually demonstration. We will use the actual Arduino board, we will connect it, and we see the demonstration how it works actually, not virtually. And the part 3, after doing this, we will cover in the theory part, what is a variable an operator, as I said. Then let's start with the component details. The component list is nothing but we required Arduino board. Might be you can use the Uno or might be use the Mega. Okay, next we required the RGB LED light, that is nothing but 5mm RGB LED light with common cathodes. It look like this, the 4 leads are there. Okay, after that 3 resistance are required. One is 330 ohms and 2 for 220 ohms. If this size here, this type of resistance are not available, then nearby value also you can use for this project. The hookup wires, mill to mill wires are required, and last, solderless breadboard. The link of all this component is available in description box. You can check it, and if you want to purchase, you can purchase from there also. What is RGB LED? RGB LED is nothing but red, green, blue light emitting diode, the full form of RGB LED. Or more simply we can say RGB LED normally we say. The RGB LED works of a similar principle as television and computer monitor works. As in the monitor we can see, normally if you are going to purchase a television, then we are saying we want LED type of TV. Previously the LCD TV is available, but right now LED previous. That means there also we are using the similar principle. Now this form of color mixing should sound familiar. Why color mixing? Because we are using the 3 color, no doubt RGB LED. But if you are mixing these 2 color, we are getting new color. Like this, here we are getting the yellow, here something, here is something. And we are mixing all these 3 color, we are getting this color. Means with the help of RGB light, we can create a number of colors. Because of that, he said this form of color mixing should sound familiar from secondary school science. Means from secondary schools, we are learning this all color mixing techniques. Based on that, RGB light works. Now, what is exactly RGB? RGB, as I said, it look like this. The 4 leads are there. If we are keeping the longest lead on the left side, then according to that, we are assigning the number 1, 2, 3. 1 indicates red. This is a lead. Yeah, this pin is for red. Second number, the longest, is for ground. The third for blue. And last lead is for green. As the name is RGB, but number is not sequence, red is here, green is here, and blue is here, and second one is a green. Then by keeping this terminology, the numbering system, we are connecting with the Arduino board. Pin number 1, we need to connect 330 ohms, and after that 330 ohms, that we need to connect with pin number 9. by pin number 9, we can check in the code. After that, the pin number 2, as I said, pin number 2 is for ground. Then directly we need to connect ground. Pin number 3, we need to connect 220 ohms. And from 220 ohms, we need to connect pin number 11. Why we are not connecting pin number 10? As we need to follow the sequence after 9, why we are jumping the 11? Already I said, it is not a proper sequence. As I said, we are using the RGB light. Red is here and green is pin number 4. And this one is a blue. Because of that blue, we are connecting pin number 11. And green with 220 ohms, we need to connect 10. By which here we can get the sequence RGB. Red, green, and last one is a, this one is a blue. Then same manner, you need to do the circuit diagram. We need to connect the component in breadboard. And after that, we are doing the coding in IDE software, the Arduino IDE software. Then to write the coding, the various syntaxes are available. If your logic is good, then you can execute the same command in various forms. Then we will see the two forms one by one. The first will be the first form, simplest form, that we are having the two loops, white setup and white loop. Okay, two whites are available in Arduino. White setup that executed once time, and white loop which is continuously executing. Then first we will see the white setup. Under the white setup, pin mode 9 comma output, that already we learn in the part 2. What exactly the meaning of this? This is a function by which we can define from which pin we are getting the output or input. Then here we are defining the set the digital outputs. The pin number 9 is output, 10 also output, and 11 also. Why? Because 9, 10, 11 we are connected with RGB, the three pins of RGB LED. After that, while loop digital write 9 comma high, we are saying 9 high, 9 we are connecting the pin number red. That means we are saying the system is on the red line. After switch on the red line, red light at the delay of 2000 milliseconds, that means 2 seconds, we are saying please on the digital write 10 comma high. Means we are saying please on the green light should on and 9 should be low, that 9 should be off. That means after red, green should be on, and again 2 second 11, that means blue on, green off. And after the delay of 4 second, that this light should be off. Again we need to off the blue light, and again we need to on the red light. Like this we are getting the red, green, blue sequence from this code. If you type this code in the same manner in an IDE software of Arduino, and if you burn this code in Arduino board, you will achieve the required flow and required output. But that is not a right way to write a syntax. Why? Because I am giving this code for the third party, and if he is referring this code without this comment line, then it is very complicated to understand what exactly the flow is going on, because we don't know pin number 9, which pin is connected, pin number 10, where is connected, pin number 8. For that purpose, I need to refer the circuit diagram. But if you write in some another form, by which from the code itself I come to know that what exactly the flow is going on, then that is a better way of writing the code. Then that I'm going to explain the same logic in various forms. Might be the flow of this code is lengthy, but it is a proper way. Why? Just see. Now here everything is same. Void setup, void loop, void support, three modes are required. As is here, three modes are required. And void loop, same. Digital write, delay, digital write, write, delay, write, write. The same flow is there. Only difference is there. Here I am writing the 9, 10, 11, 9, 10, 11, 2000, numbers are there. But here I write some words. That word is nothing but the variables. I defined here the variables at the starting of the code. Because of that, this 4 line is increased. Red of the lines are same. Then here I have defined the red as a 9. Then wherever I written the 9 in the previous code, that is a normal writing of the code, there I am writing the red. Pin mode red, digital write red, digital write red low. Then just see here, write high, 9 low. Then same where I am writing the red, and similarly where I written the 10, there I am writing the green, green, green. And similarly where I write in the time, just here 2000 2000 2000, but writing right now I am writing the time, and here I define the variable name as a time. Then might be you think that why I am making the code so much complicated, but that is a useful also. Why? Because suppose in future pin number 9 is not working in my Arduino boot. It is a simple code, only I need to, if I want to change the pin, I need to change only 3 values. But suppose the code length is 1500 lines, like code is there, it might be 500 lines codes are there, and I want to change this pin number 9. instead of pin number 9, now I'm thinking, no, pin number 9 is not working. I need to connect the pin number 8 or pin number 7. Then in that case, you need to change each and every line where you written the 9. Then you have to write down the 7 or 8 pin number where you are connecting the pins. But in this type of coding method, then what you have to do, only you need to change in this line. Instead of trying to write down the 7, then everywhere by default the red value, that is 7, is taken. Okay, similarly time, I decided initially I want a delay of 2 seconds. Red should be on for the 2 seconds, after that red off and green on for the 2 seconds. Similarly, the same thing I can increase for 4 seconds, 5 seconds, 6 seconds. Instead of keeping the changing the delay everywhere, I am just change the delay over here in the time. Instead of 2000, if I make it the 4000, then everywhere I am getting the delay of 4 seconds. Instead of 4 seconds, suppose I record 1 second, then here I done the 1 second because here taking in the millisecond. Okay, if I adding the 1000 millisecond, that means a 1 second. And here, as I am using the compound, it gives a twice the value, 1000 multiplied by 2 means 2000. Okay, that is a benefit of writing the code in this manner by using the variable and compound operator. It is easy to write the code in proper manner and it is easy to modify it in future. Okay, that is a more sufficient, might be you understand code properly. Let's see the live demonstration how the code is working.
Let's see the circuit diagram. I made the circuit according to whatever the circuit I explained in previously, the same way. This is a pin number 1, okay. Pin number 1 I connect with the 330 ohms and with red wire. Pin number 2 is a ground, which is I connect to white wire. Pin number 3 is blue, okay, which I connected with this resistance, and after that it is connected with the blue wire. And last pin is a green, which is connected to this resistance, and this is a connected with green wire. Okay, and according to that I made the connection over here. You can see in this Arduino, the red one I connect with the 9, green one with the 10, blue one with the 11. For better understanding, I select the color also same, and the white one I'm using the ground. Okay. Now hope it will be visible clearly the wiring also. Then I made the connection according to that whatever I explained previously at the time of video lecture. Now what I will do, already I made the code and I connected with the system. Okay, that USB cable, with the help of USB cable I connected the system. Let's upload the code, which code I discussed previously. Okay, for that purpose I will open the RGB LED, the code which is I saved. Open the RGB LED and let's verify first. As I explained, we need to verify it, save it, and after that we need to upload it. It's compiling, verifying is done. That means our code is correct. Now let's upload, and you can check in the video when I'm pressing the upload what will happen. Light will blink. Okay, light is blinking and it started. Blue, red, green, blue, red, green, blue. At the delay of 2 seconds, I'm getting 3 colors. Okay, you can make the changes, you can change the delay, and you can create your own circuit, your own combination also. Okay, let's continue with our video lecture.
Okay, great. I hope you understood how the code is working in actual Arduino board, and you understood the code properly, and you see what is the use of variable and operator in previous code. But let's see in detail what exactly the variable, because that is not the case. The variable I'm going to use in RGB LED, I need to use in future also, but in which manner we can use the variable, that we will learning in detail this theory part. What exactly the variable? Variable is in a container of information. It is a container where I am storing the information. Like a previous case, red equal to 9. That means red is a variable inside I am storing the value number 9. Variable name tell us what data is contained. That variable name we need to write down in such a manner that we should come to know what exactly data is contained. As example in previous code, I written the red is equal to 9. That means I am defining the red pin number. We can easily understand from the word red. It is used to store number which is constantly changing. As I said, suppose I want to change the pin number, yeah, I want to change the time, then that time also variable is used. When we want to declare variable, we require the following things. That whenever we need to declare the variables, just keep these two things in your mind. That first, what is the variable name, and second, what exactly is the data type. Why data type? Because in a previous case in coding, I define int int int. That means I'm defining the integer. Similarly, various other data types also there that is useful in some other types of coding. For that purpose, you should know what are the different types of data type. Okay, let's see. First, variable name. How to write the variable name? The variable name should contain only letters, numbers, or underscore. What is the exact underscore? As you see under below, I written the word underscore, and below I write down the underline. That is called as underscore. Then inside the variable, I only use the letter, number, and underscore. Excluding the underscore, if I am using another special character or space, that is not allowed in Arduino programming. So space or other special characters are not allowed. First character also cannot be a number, means it should start the letter only. If I am starting with a number, it is an invalid. Valid name, just see my variable, my value, I am not keeping any space. I am writing in a capital letter, no issue. Capital delay minus capital time, it is also welcome because underscore is also common. Value 1 is allowed, but invalid variable name is 1 value. Same thing is there, instead of 1 I am writing at, I am starting at initial. But as I said, first letter cannot be a number, then is invalid name. Delay, space, time, as I said space is not allowed, this one also invalid number. Time and value, this is a special character, as I said a special character, only underscore is allowed. And this type of under special character is not allowed, then this also invalid name. By keeping this thing in your mind, if you are writing the variable name, then it will be accepted by this software, otherwise it shows a error. Now next, writing the naming, the variable naming guideline, how to write the name. That means if you writing the delay underscore time, that is also okay. My value, that is also okay. My variable name is also a value 1, that is also okay. But if you are writing some, by following some guideline, that it will be easy to understand for you and for other person also exactly what I written over there. Then various methods are there. For example, variable name in contain the variable words, but we have to constant of space in a variable name. Therefore, means we need to find some constant of space. Constant of space is there. Because of that, we need to define the variable properly. Otherwise, we can write the number multiple words like 4, 5, 7, 8. But that is a very lengthy to type. Therefore, one options we have as underscore. Okay. Or we can use the camelback notation. Means if I want to write the multiple words, I can use the space or camelback notation. Both are possible. The first letter of the, but I am giving the suggestion, just use the camelback notation, because most of the syntax of Arduino also written in the same syntax. If you are writing the variable name in a camelback notation, then you will get the benefit of writing the other function also. You will not make a mistake of writing that function's name. The first letter, what is the camelback notation? The first letter of the first word, first letter of first word will be lowercase. Whatever the first letter is there, first word, it also lowercase. And which the first letter of each subsequent word after that, whatever the words are there, it will be the capitalized with no space between the each word. We are having the space means underscore option, but we are not using the underscore. What we are using, suppose I want to write a data type of a variable name, then I need to write everything in a small letters. But suppose my variable name is my variable name, my variable, for example, as I'm using the two words, my is different word and variable is different word. Then first word my, I need to write down the lowercase, and after that variable first letter will be capital, and after that all the letters are small. Just see the last one, tilde switch wall, then here three words are there, then tilde all letters should be small. Second switch, first letter should be capital, rest of the small. Third value, first letter V should be capital and rest of the alphabet should be small. Like this you need to write down the variable name, that is a camelback notation. If you are using the number, no need, everything should be small. But if you are using the words, that time you need to follow this procedure. That is the guideline for writing the variable name. Might be you saw that pin mode, that word we used in the coding, then that pin is small and pin mode, and mode is mode, M is capital. Because of that, same various function name also using the following the same notation. Then if you are following the same thing in a variable name, then is a well and good. If you are not following, then also your code will be executed properly if you are following the previous rules, whatever explained the previous slide. Now what are the data types? Now next, various type of data types available like boolean, byte, character, integer, long, float, that we need to use according to requirement. For example, if suppose I want to define a for example, I need to define pin numbers as we used previously, but instead of int, I use the int. You can use the character also, or you can use the byte also. That is also possible, because the size of variable will be reduces. If I'm using the more number of pins, then definitely I need to go with the bytes and character. If I'm using the less number of inputs, then I can use the integer also, because I'm having the more space. But if space problems are there, that I'm using the bytes. But suppose I'm using some kind of calculation. In that calculation, I need the values increase more than 32,767, because the integer having the limitation, it goes up to minus 32,768 till positive 32,767. If more than that values are required, might be in a lax, okay, then I need to switch in the long. Okay, long is nothing but again 32 byte, in which I can store the value up to we can say 10 digit. Okay, I think so. This is the 10 digit number, in a negative 10 digit and positive also 10 digit, or more than if required, then we can use the float. But normally we are avoiding the float type of variable data type in Arduino, because the processor cycle is very small. As we say, processor is not that much powerful. Then if as much as possible we need to use the int, if required then we can use the float also. The sizes are boolean 1 bit, byte 8 bit, character 8 bit, integer 16 bit is required, and long and for 32 bit of memories is required. The last part, operators. The various type of operators are available, like assignment, arithmetic, compound. Other operators are also available, we will see in future. What is assignment operator? Assignment operator is nothing but equal to sign. That means equal to sign is nothing but what we learn in mathematics. Left hand side is equal to right hand side. That is not nothing but equal to sign over here. Equal to sign is nothing but here I'm declaring some value to the variable. For example, int my value and new value, I'm defining two values, and my value I'm storing 225. That means I'm assigning 255 value to my value. Next line, new value is equal to my value. That means I'm assigning new value to the my value, whatever the value I store. Means inside of my value I'm storing 255. That means I'm assigning 255 to new value. Because of that is called assignment operator. That is not equal to sign, it is assignment operator. Next, arithmetic operator. What exactly is arithmetic operator? The simple arithmetic operator are add, subtract, multiply and division. Now suppose in 199 I want to add one more value, then I will use the arithmetic operator, the positive sign. My value is equal to my value plus 1. Then previous value is 199 plus 1 200. Now my value, the 200 is stored. Now the my new value is 200, previously is 199, but as I added one inside through this line, a new value is available in my value is 2000. Suppose I want to do division, I can write int my value is equal to 9/5. But just keep this thing in your mind while doing such type of operation. As my value data type is integer, cannot store the floating decimal points, okay, then output of this value inside the my value 1 will be stored instead of 1.8. according to your culture it should be 1.8, but as I'm defining the integer, inside the my value only 1 value will be stored, not 1.8. If you want to store 1.8, you need to use the float. Next is the compound operator. What exactly is a compound operator, right? Compound operators are nothing but if I'm using the arithmetic operator two times continuously, okay, in the combination, that is called as a compound operator. For example, previously I shown the example, suppose I want to add one value, then in that case I need to write down the value. My value is equal to 199 semicolon, next line, my value is equal to my value plus 1. Means in my value I'm adding one value, and new value here I'm getting 2000, as I explained previously. But same thing I can write down with the help of this type of syntax, in which my value is equal to 199 semicolon, my value plus plus colon. That plus plus indicates in my value I want to add one more value, then that will be reduce the typing effort, and I can write down the code in short way. That is the benefit of compound operator. That is not restricted to addition, we can do the subtraction also, or we can use more than instead of one. I'm using only plus plus, then I'm adding one. If I'm using only minus minus, that I'm subtracting one. But I want to add multiple factor, more than one, in that case I need to use plus equal to sign. That means I want to add in my value 10 value more. Means instead of 199 it should be 209. If I want to subtract minus 10, in that case minus equal to sign I need to write down. And last, as I said, suppose I want to multifactor, multiplication, means I need to increase this value 5 times, and I can write down the my value is equal to 2 semicolon, my value is equal to star, this is a multiplication equal to 5. That means I'm storing in my value 10s, because 2 multiplied by 5, 10. That is all about the operator and variable. Want to learn more, you can refer this book, Beginning Arduino Programming, or you can refer the www.arduino.cc/forum if you are having any doubt in coding. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. You can check my previous series, the Introduction to Mechatronics, second series, Electrical Actuating Systems, in which I cover the DC motor, stepper motor, voice coil actuator, and how to deliver a pneumatic system. Okay, basics till development stage I explained. The series is available on my channel, you can visit on my channel. Simply you need to type this on Google or a taskbar, www.youtube.com/mrkhanacademy. My channel page will be open. And do not forget to hit the subscribe my channel. Subscribe my channel to motivate me to make such video in future also. Hit the like button, share this video with your friends also. And if you have any doubt, any comment, please mention in comment box. Thank you very much. Bye bye. See you soon. Take care.